Minasan, konnichiwa. A lot of topics today as well, since the amount of content and updates related to the Japan border keep increasing. Today we will be talking about a social media photo event we are organizing, Malaysian short-term students in Japan, Minister Taro comment on students, Go to Travel campaign restarting, possibly soon, Indonesian ambassador contact, G7 meeting on international travel results, and a plunge of university enrollments in Japan, and also a petition for Sophia University. We are almost ready to get started. As always, if you are new to the channel and want to keep yourself updated on info about the Japan travel ban, please don't forget to subscribe. For everyone else, please support my work liking and sharing this video. First, I want to talk about a new initiative for international students. We have discussed with schools and media to find the best step for our cause. It's important to follow up as soon as possible after former Prime Minister Suga's words. So we decided to organize a photo campaign on social media to keep awareness of the issue high. On the 15th of October, we will have a social media photo event. We are asking students stranded outside Japan to share a photo of themselves with their name, country, and how long each student has been waiting. We will also advertise this to Japanese people and media. When you share on Twitter and Instagram, please use these three hashtags: Education is not tourism, Open the borders to students, Nyoryuga kunoto biraho iraku. Please also upload the photo to us using the Google Form link provided in the YouTube description, so we can share easily the photos to Japanese media. From my sources and the politician we have spoken, the government is finally ready to move to the next step to open the borders. But because of the coming elections, public opinion is very important. The conversation has now shifted and is no more a matter of if, neither of when. The government is willing to reopen the borders, and now they're figuring out how they can do it safely and also in a way that is not criticized by the Japanese people. Since cases now are relatively low and the vaccination campaign is going well, we really need to all work together for one or maybe two more pushes. I know some of you have been waiting for almost 2 years. You have lost time, energy and money because of the current situation. Many of you have already cancelled or changed destination to another country. But there's still so many of you out there that don't want to cancel, or they cannot cancel or change destination. This is why I and my team are doing everything we can for you to get the borders open as early as possible. I understand that sometimes it's very frustrating to see my updates each week where I still can give the big news everyone is waiting. The borders are open. I really, really want to do that. I want to do it soon. But complicated things, like the thing we're trying to achieve, are not achieved overnight. It takes time. Yes, this is taking a lot of time. Too much time, I would say. Maybe one day, when you will finally hear that workers, students, families, and couples can enter Japan, you may think that that was decided quickly, maybe on the day you hear. But believe me, especially in Japan, that's not going to be the case. It's our actions in the previous months. It's our actions today and tomorrow that will accelerate the decision to open the borders. Of course, it's not just us. There are a lot of people and organizations working hard every day to help the borders to open. Please don't think that all the work that all these people are doing is useless, because it isn't. Moving on, other news. 31 Malaysian students enter Japan to study short term. They're also government-sponsored students. I'm very happy for them to be able to enter Japan. This surely shows that Japan is slowly reopening and including more groups who are able to enter. So this is a good news for other categories waiting to enter Japan as well. But it is still very sad that while some categories can enter, some other who have the same rights and desire to come to Japan still can't. I really hope that the government fix this soon. I want to thank Ryan for asking a question about international students to Minister Taro. Minister Taro's reply was, "We should think soon to let foreign students and spouses who are stranded outside Japan for over 1 year to enter Japan. For example, with 2 weeks quarantine and PCR. He specifically used the word sorosoro, which means soon. I think this is another positive sign about the intention to reopen the border soon. The newly appointed Ministry of Land Infrastructure, Transport and Tourism, Saito, commented about restarting the Go to Travel campaign. We will consider the situation regarding novel coronavirus infections and consider when to resume the program. Go to Travel is a program to support and promote domestic travel through reduction of price and also coupon system. This is funded by the government. My personal thought on this is that you can't restart a program that will move millions of people inside Japan but keep the borders shut to new residents. You either are still very concerned about the virus and block travel entirely, or you want to reopen and restart the economy, so you also reopen the borders, safely of course. I really hope that when the restart go to, they also announce they are reopening the borders. I saw on Twitter someone who suggested to write to the Japan ambassador in Indonesia, who seems to be very active on Twitter. Since many of you are following my channel from Indonesia, I thought to share this and just let me know if you get any response from the ambassador. In my last week video, I mentioned a G7 meeting between transport ministers about reopening to international travel. Transport secretary agrees high-level principle with G7 leaders to support international and transatlantic travel. I would have liked to see a specific comment about reciprocity, since Japan is the only country in the G7 not accepting students, workers and families from other G7 countries, while Japanese people, even tourists from Japan, can go to any other G7 countries. Unfortunately, there wasn't such a statement. New enrollments at 46% of private universities are not filled for 2021, a decrease of around 26,000 in the 18-year-old population, and the fact that international students are banned to enter Japan due to the coronavirus pandemic are believed to be the factors in the low enrollments. Usually, foreign students take 1 to 2 years after attending a Japanese language school to enroll to a university. Japan has closed the borders in March 2020 to students and other type of visas. Japanese language schools noticed the sudden increase of students right away, and since last year they have asked the government to reopen the borders. Universities and vocational schools are lagging 2 years, but now that they are closing April 2022 applications and they see the number for next year, they can finally see the huge impact of the Japan travel ban. I expect very soon also universities to be actively pressuring the government to reopen the borders for students. Yesterday, I was contacted by a Sofia University student to sign a petition to extend Sofia University's international student entry deadline. Sofia is forcing students to enter Japan by the 31st of October, or they need to cancel the study. Since there is a chance of the borders opening, for example, in November, the petition asks to extend this deadline. You can find more details in the description. Even if you are not a Sofia student, please support Sofia students signing the petition. Thank you so much again for watching the video. Overall, it was a positive week for us, even though unfortunately there hasn't been the announcement yet. I will continue to work with you to ask the government to reopen the border. If you are a student, please remember to upload your photo on Google Form and on Twitter and Instagram on the 15th of October. In the next few days, I will actually be traveling for my company Gogo Nihon in Fukuoka, Oita, Osaka and Kobe. If there is anything that you would like me to do and film, then please let me know in the comments and maybe I'll make a special video for you. Since most of the viewers of my channel are foreigners who cannot enter Japan right now, let me also know in the comment if you prefer instead for me to don't show things from Japan until you can enter, since I don't want to hurt anyone's feelings. In either case, let me know in the comments and please stay positive. Thank you very much for watching and matane. Bye!